Modules and the module system are fundamental parts of how Node.js applications are written and structured. They allow us to better organize, reuse, and distribute our code. In this tutorial, we'll explore how the module system helps us write better code, understand the different types of modules, list ways to export code from a module, and review how the require function works. First up, let's talk about what a module is. As we said before, modules are the building blocks of Node.js. Modules are units of code organized into a file or directory that allows us to export functionality so we can include it elsewhere in an application. Put simply, modules let us reuse code that we or someone else have already written. Each file in Node.js has a global object in its scope called module. The module object holds information about that specific file. That special, globally available module object has a property on it called exports. Assigning values to the module.exports object will expose them for inclusion anywhere else in your application. Creating a module is as simple as assigning values to the module.exports object, or even overriding the module.exports object with whatever other value you wish. Every file in Node can be a module, they all have a module object in the scope, but not every file needs to export code. You can certainly write your entire application in one single giant file, but that quickly becomes very hard to maintain. Code is broken up into modules to maintain separation of concerns and create, well, a more modular structure in your code. So modules are both functional and technically stylistic. There are three main types of modules you're likely to encounter in Node.js: built-in modules, local modules, and external modules. They all function similarly in that they rely on the module system in the same way, but they differ mainly in where they come from. Built-in modules are distributed with Node.js itself. An example would be the HTTP module, which provides the low-level functionality to create servers and clients. You don't have to actually download built-in modules from anywhere. They are available as a standard part of the language for any Node.js project to use. Built-in modules make up the common core functionality of the language. Built-in modules are often referred to as the standard library of Node.js. They are a small number of important pieces of functionality without which the language wouldn't be nearly as useful. Built-in modules are maintained by core contributors to the Node.js project. As a result, they are fairly stable. They only change with new releases of Node.js itself. Because so many other projects rely on built-in modules, they often maintain backwards compatibility when changes are made. Local modules are modules which you write yourself and are part of your actual code base. Local modules are how you reuse code that you've written within your application. An example would be creating a module to organize various utility functions you've written which are specific to your application. You can reuse these utility functions anywhere in your project by including them from the module. That way, they're not scattered or duplicated across your code base. These types of modules are part of the application code you write yourself, and as a result, they're checked into version control. That's a contrast to built-in modules, which are a part of the Node.js language itself and are not directly part of the code you've written. Your local modules can use built-in modules, but the built-in module isn't part of your actual code base as it's provided by the language. So in short, local modules are typically the code you write yourself. Finally, an external module is a module which isn't directly part of your code base and isn't a built-in module provided by the language. They are any module which you install as an external dependency into your project. External modules can essentially be summed up by saying that they're NPM packages. They will live in your Node modules directory once installed from whatever the external source is. When you're using an NPM package, you're using an external module. External modules aren't part of your codebase. What we mean by that is that you don't check them into version control. Instead, we track them in our package.json with an associated version number so that they can be retrieved by the NPM CLI when installing dependencies. This keeps the code of your dependencies separate from your application code and keeps your Git history clean from tracking changes in code that you didn't write. The module system we have today is largely an extension of something called the Common JS Standard. When Node.js first came onto the scene, it had no standardized module system. Common JS was picked and extended as the standard module system that the Node.js ecosystem is using today. At its simplest, we use the module system by exporting code from one file to be reused in another. To do that, we assign values to the module.exports object in the file we would like to export functionality from. To then include the code exported from one module into another file, we pass the module's file path to the require function, which returns the values assigned to module.exports. Here's an example of a simple local module which exports a single function. The name of this file is math.js, and we are exporting the function multiply by 2 by overwriting the value of module.exports. In any given file, we can assign values to the module.exports object or overwrite the object completely with a new value to export code from the file. In this example, we're overwriting the value of module.exports, so it's not actually an object anymore, it's resolving just to the function. Then in another file, we load the module by passing a relative path to the math.js file to the require function. On line 3, we're logging the return value of multiply by 2, which in this case should be 20. On line 7, we're console logging what was returned by the require statement. You'll see that it's the multiply by 2 function which we exported from the math.js module. In this example, we only exported a single function from the math.js module. It's more common that you want to export multiple functions from one module, so let's go ahead and do that now. Okay, I've updated the math.js module to export multiple functions. Let's look at what's different between this and the previous one. One of the first things you should notice is that on line 11, we're exporting an object instead of a single function. Here we're assigning an object to module.exports. This object has the properties multiply by 2, add, and subtract. Essentially though, not much has changed. We're still declaring our functions at the top of the file and then exporting once at the bottom of the file. The major difference is just simply that this time we're exporting an object instead of a single function. I've also updated the other file that requires the math.js module. Not a lot has changed here either. The main difference is on line 1. Because require is returning an object instead of just a single function, I changed the name of the variable to math to reflect that it holds not just one function, but multiple math functions. And then on line 3, we're still using the multiply by 2 function, but this time we're accessing it on the math object by using dot notation. And finally, on line 6, we're console logging what was returned by the require function. I'm going to go ahead and run this file so you can see for yourself what math contains. There you have it. You see the 20, which was console logged from line 3, and then also you see the object which math represents. The math object, like we said before, holds 3 keys, multiply by 2, add, and subtract, which each point to a function of the same name. Another way to export multiple values from a module is by using the exports object, which is an alias of module.exports. Exports is also available in the global scope of a file. You can use the exports object and dot notation to assign values to module.exports. Here's what the math.js module would look like if we use the export style of exports. This is functionally the same as the previous way we did things, where we assigned an object directly to module.exports. Adding properties to exports is essentially a shorthand way of adding properties to module.exports. You can use either style, but don't mix them up, because if you use exports like this, and then you later assign something to module.exports, you'll lose all the references you had on the exports object. Let's talk about the require function for a moment, because module.exports is only half of the module system. To load a module, you have to use the built-in and globally available require function. We load modules by passing in the name of the module for built-in and external modules, and for local modules, we pass a file path to the module itself. The require function will look up the module or file, figure out what kind of file it is, and then evaluate the code in the file, return the value of module.exports, and then cache the result. Caching the result means that if the module is required elsewhere, the file won't have to be read, and instead require will return the result from the first time it was required, without rerunning the code in the module. We can demonstrate this evaluation and caching behavior with a simple file with just a single console.log statement in it. Here we have a file called sample-module.js, which contains a console log saying I was required. Then, from another file, which I've named require test, we're going to require the sample module twice and see what happens. I'll run the require test file from the terminal, and you can see that it console logs once. What happens is that when you require a file, it evaluates the code which is inside of it. So it actually will run whatever code you have in that file and then return the module.exports object. The console log only ran once because the result of require was cached already from the first one, so it didn't have to reevaluate the file, so it didn't run any of the code inside of it. You probably notice that the sample module file doesn't even use module.exports. That's fine. You can require a file that doesn't export anything. The require statement will just return undefined. One last thing about require. If you pass a path to a directory to the require function, it will look for an index.js file in the directory and load that if found. This lets you organize a module into smaller modules inside one directory, load them into the index.js file in that directory, and then export a single object from that file. By now you might be wondering, what about the import and export keywords I've seen used in projects before? You may have heard about ECMAScript modules, which are also called ESM. The import and export keywords are used to work with the module system in ESM. This is the next generation of the module system for JavaScript and is currently only supported behind experimental flags for the latest version of Node.js, which is version 12 at the time of recording. To use ESM and import and export statements in your code today, you need to transpile the code with a tool like Babel. What this does behind the scenes is compile your import and export statements back to the common JS format. So you end up still using common JS format with module.exports and require statements under the hood of your project. When developing applications for the front end, it's very common to transpile your code before it goes into production. This helps to ensure that your front end code runs in as many browsers as possible, and that's why you see import and export statements so frequently in front end codebases. However, when working in Node.js and building backend applications, there is no real need for transpilation, because we control the environment that the code is running in. We don't need to transpile our code to run in different browsers, because for the most part, it's just running on a server that we control. The extra step of compilation isn't nearly as useful there. In this tutorial, we chose to focus on the common JS format of modules, using require and module.exports, because it is still currently the standard for Node.js. ESM is the future of the module system, but it isn't currently supported by Node.js natively, and still has a long way to go before ESM spec is locked down and implemented in Node.js. Basically, common JS style modules aren't going away anytime soon, and so it's important you understand them first before working with ESM. To recap, in this tutorial, we explored how the module system helps us write better code. We learned about the different types of modules, which are built-in modules, external modules, and local modules. We listed different ways to export code from a module, and we reviewed how the require function works.